Archbishop of York has called for the government to offer asylum to those being persecuted by Islamic State jihadists. Dr. John Sentamu says he fears the situation in Syria and Iraq could end in genocide. He told the BBC One programme Sunday Morning Live there could be a repeat of the massacres in Rwanda in 1994.
They've already shown their capacity for, you know, really being bloodthirsty and killing people. I mean, the beheading of Foley, really, that should tell us this is a very ruthless group of people, and somehow they've got to be stopped, because if you don't stop them, we may end up with a genocide.
And it's against that backdrop that more than 30,000 Muslims are gathering in Hampshire to mark the UK's oldest Muslim convention. This year's gathering is looking at ways to tackle extremism and is hoping to defend religious freedom for everybody. The Ahmadiyya Muslim community is celebrating its 125th year in the UK, and Taher Nasser is from Coventry and one of those attending. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. Lovely to talk to you.
And yourself.
You've clearly got a busy day. Tell people who don't know about the Ahmadiyya Muslim community.
Well, the Ahmadiyya Muslim community is a reformation movement within Islam, which claims to be the prophesied reformatory movement within Islam that would occur by the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, when Islam would undergo both a spiritual and a material degradation in its latter period.
And getting together with a whole load of people from the community, how do you hope to tackle extremism?
Well, I think extremism is only flourishes really with ignorance. Ignorance actually of the true teachings of Islam. And so the entire purpose of the what's known as the Jalsa Salana, which basically translates loosely as annual convention, the entire purpose of it is to create a spiritual atmosphere whereby people come together and they learn more about the teachings of Islam, and they develop spiritually as spiritual beings. And that is the entire purpose of the Jalsa. And extremism only flourishes in actual fact when you have an absence of understanding of Islam. Islam is a very peaceful religion. It is a religion that actually means peace, peace that is attained through submitting to God and through serving one's fellow human beings.
I always find it extraordinary. I've read the Quran, and as you say, peace is the overriding theme of it. I find it difficult to comprehend how people read the Quran and get a different message from. I mean, we've been talking about it on the programme for a number of weeks. Where do you think extremism comes from? One of our guests last week said, well, it comes through social media. People go on Twitter, they find people that are more extreme in their views, they stop going to moderate mosques.
Yeah.
Is that what happens?
I completely agree with you. As for reading the Quran, I mean, you know, every single chapter of the Quran, bar one, so like some over 100 chapters, begins with the words, in the name of God, the most gracious, the ever merciful. So, you know, God is continually introduced as a God of love and as a God of mercy and grace. I think in terms of where extremism comes from, I don't think you can just say it comes from social media or it comes from, you know, these particular types of mosques. Extremism is not a phenomenon which is just 2 weeks old or 2 months old or the beginning of ISIS. It's a phenomenon that spans all religions, actually, and it's a phenomenon that spans all movements. You get extremists who are involved, you know, extremist environmentalists as well. So you have to ask yourself, where does that come from? Where does extremism itself come from? In relation to Islam, I think that extremism is very much a political movement. And if you look at all of the hopes and the aspirations of people like ISIS, people like the Taliban, people like Al-Qaeda, all of their hopes and aspirations are political in nature. They are using and they are utilizing the name of Islam because Islam is such a potent force in the world for good. And they are representing their own plan and their own agenda as a good thing to their own people, and thereby try seeking to use the name of Islam for their political ends. I mean, this so-called caliphate that has come up in ISIS in Syria, what are they doing? They're going around conquering land. That is it's a territorial thing. It's nothing to do with conquering of hearts and conquering of, you know, of bad people's habits and their sins and their evils and ridding them of that, which is actually the true and the underlying purpose of all religions.
And can you get the counter message out there?
Absolutely. I mean, that's what we're doing right now, aren't we? And the reality is the Jalsa Salana, the annual convention that we've been going to, this is the 48th year of it, and it's held not only in our country, but the Ahmadiyya Muslim community spans 206 countries of the world and runs into tens of millions. And we're all united behind one caliph. And now we've had caliphate for 106 years. So it's astonishing almost for us that this person should come along and claimed to be the Caliph of Islam, and he should in actual fact be thought to represent Islam, or Islam should get such a bad name with him, whereas we've actually had a caliphate of peace and of prosperity and of love and of teaching people to rid themselves of their evils for 106 years. And we have been spreading all over the world through this single guided leader whose name is Mirza Mansur Ahmad, who is the fifth caliph, who became the caliph in 2003. So it is a... we think we are getting the message out there, definitely.
You've certainly done that very eloquently this morning. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you very much, no
problem. Tahir Nasser from the Ahmadiyya Muslim community from Coventry, been going to be at that convention today.